Lastly, we have constant objects. So constant members and objects. Well, what is a const object? It tells us that the object is not modifiable. So we know from C that we can make basic types and objects constant, like A is a constant integer. So the problem here in C++ is that in C++ we have methods, and methods are theoretically able to change the object's state. Yeah, like, and that's the problem. So, and we don't know if it's valid to call such a method, because such a method should not, for a const object, should not be able to change it. Well, therefore, in C++, you can create so-called const member functions. They indicate that this object is not manipulated inside the function. So it's basically a little bit like a pure function, so where pure functions are a bit more strict. Yeah, so here we have declared testFunc to be a const function. That means any change that you try to attempt to any data member inside this function will lead to a compiler error. So in that sense, if you have a constant object, you can only call member functions if they are declared to be const member functions. Otherwise, the compiler would say that you try to modify it. The advantage of using the strategy is that you have clear interfaces for the users, and you get kind of compile time errors when you try to modify const objects. And the compiler lastly can perform some optimizations to improve performance. So next we may have const data members. It's similar to C, so I have a class demo here where I have a private member that is declared const. But as it is declared const, I cannot change it. Well, how do I initialize it? That's the key question. Well, you can only initialize it in a constructor and only using this member initializing syntax. So here I have my constructor demo, and it takes an argument I, and it assigns to the variable m here, which is our data member, the value I. After that, it's not possible to change it. So even inside the body of this constructor, I couldn't say m equals 5 or something. That would not work. It only works here as part of the member initializer syntax. So next we have const member functions. So we know already I have to add this const keyword after my function parameter list. It must be contained in the declaration and the function definition. So what you can't do inside such a function, in a const function, you cannot modify data members, of course, because that's the purpose of this const, a const object. You cannot call non-const member functions, of course, because they may change it then on your behalf. And you cannot call non-const member functions, Right, so constructors cannot be ever const. It doesn't make any sense because they always modify objects. Here's now an example. Here I have my demo object again, and it has A, B, and C as values. A has two functions, setDemo and getABC. So for a setter, we normally need to modify the internal state, right? So it changes A, B, and C to I, J, and K in this example. So that can never be const, right? But our getter, getABC, for example, here in this case it returns A times B times C. We can declare this one as const because it doesn't change the internal state of this object at all, right? It just is read only. Yeah, so that's kind of how this works. And now I can use it in my main code by creating here a C object that is const, and I have a D object that is not const. So for the D object, I can, of course, call the getter, and I can call the setter by changing the internal state. For C object, I can get the internal state, like using getABC, because getABC was declared const, right? So it means it works for constant objects. C is const, so it works. However, when I try to call the set function, setDemo, with certain values, the compiler will return an error message, indicating that you try to modify a constant object. Exactly what we wanted to do. So So it prevents us to make an illegal modification. So you might wonder, why is it needed that in the declaration we have const here as an additional keyword? Well, it's really necessary because the compile time, at compile time, when we make the implementation, we have to ensure as a compiler that we don't modify any member variable, so we can do that easily. But then when we try to build user code that uses our function over here, the compiler not necessarily knows that such a function does not modify the code anymore. So therefore, it's now part of the declaration, with the declaration as well as a user and the implementation, both sides we can do some checks. Yeah, here we see the error message. If we would like use the G++ compiler, that's part of the GNU C++ collection. So we get here error, passing const demo as this argument discards qualifier. My goodness. So we have to understand what that means, but it basically means you try to access a const object in your function. So to wrap up today's talk, we know we recognize that good practice means to encapsulate our data. It means to use constant interfaces, const data members, and const functions that allow us to provide access to const objects. We should handle all potential errors and outputting a message as needed, or handle them gracefully as much as we can. We should use C++ casts instead of C casts, while we can still continue to use the C casts for backwards compatibility. Exceptions are a professional way to deal with errors. So you basically throw errors and they are escalated until they are somewhere catched and handled properly. Lastly, we talked about dynamic casts as well, which is a safe way of casting an object to a child class. So I wish you a